Друзья, приветствую! Помимо Ютуба я решил завести себе канал в Телеграме, где кроме обзоров вас ждут видео с шайбами наших игроков, различные видеоподборки и топы, а также новости про лучшую лигу мира. А еще под каждым постом есть комментарии, где можно высказать свое мнение, если тема вам интересна. Буду очень рад, если вы перейдете по ссылке в описании или отсканируете QR-код на экране и присоединитесь к нашей ламповой телеге.
Seth Jones on the loose puck. He'll turn, take a look, put it behind the net to his partner Brody. And Brody fires a pass out to Bertuzzi. And now Bedard by himself. Line mate's gone to the bench. Bedard trying to make something happen. He chips that towards the goal, and Fleury's able to steer it aside. Kurashev to tie up the stick of the oncoming Wild player. Prevented an opportunity right in the slot. Kaprizov to Eriksson, Ek feeds it over, Merrill with a shot, and that's the first stopper. Mrazek makes a blocker save, puts the puck up over the glass. We'll drop it off to Jones, up the board, soft skate, comes free, Craig Smith plays it to Donato, and away he goes. Three Hawks over the line, Donato in deep, put a shot on goal in the back, rebound shot wide by Big Pat Maroon. Puck comes up the near side, fed back to the line. Spurgeon plays it over, they score! Rossi goes top shelf. Late stages of the second penalty, and it's 1-0 Wild.
Well, last year he scored 19 of his 21 goals at even strength. Didn't get it. This is a heck of a play by Spurgeon, and Spurgeon's going to be the key here up on the top left of your screen. Once he takes this pass, and everybody gets lured towards him right there, and you can see Allen slides over to Johansson, and at this point here, Spurgeon does the right thing. It's just a simple little pass off to his left, and you can see that Mrazek had kind of bit, come out, challenged, and a super pass as Rossi, you can see, lips right over there to Jared Spurgeon.
And those are the hands that scored those 21 goals last season. You haven't even mentioned it yet. Oh, weird play, winds up on the net, a misplay by Mrazek. How did that go in? A dump in from center ice, and just like that, it's 2-0. And
well, that's a stunner for
wow.
Sure. I mean, there's no question about that. And a face-off win by the Minnesota Wild, gets the line, and instead of dumping it in, it was a bit of a fake. Watch the way he turns his hands over, and not only did he do that, but Mrazek actually banked it off his own pad.
Pinching down the far side is Isaac Phillips, but Minnesota able to get the puck and work it out the center ice. Long pass finds Kaprizov, cuts to the middle, feeds it over! A stop by Mrazek, puck flares across the top of the crease. Kind of has it. Was the game on Tuesday in Minnesota as well? The Wild scored goals in bunches, and they get two quick ones. But look at answer back! He's put over the backhand and shut down by Fleury.
And let's see. He gets control of it. Forehand, backhand, but
Maroon makes a pass to Vlasic. He tried to fling that towards the net, deflected across. Kurashev in the circle lets it go with a pass to Donato. Jabs at it. Fleury down, able to cover up.
Up high that created the first power play, and here it is, taken from the backhand of the forehand. And there's Merrill right there shoving him. Spurgeon also helping, but Fleury's got that puck.
Donato from the flank puts it in front. Craig Smith swats at it. Maroon looking for it. Wound up sliding between his feet. The puck's cleared down the ice by Lauko.
Shifted and he got whacked on the wrist, it looked like.
There's a giveaway. A chance now. Foligno with a shot. Stopped by Fleury out the challenge in traffic at the in the dying seconds of the power play. And Bedard leaves the puck, then gets it back. Had it taken away at center by Husnadinov. Carried over the line now. Gaudreau got a shot away. Put it wide. Big bounce off the inboards. Right back in front. Mrazek with a big save off Gaudreau.
That was funny, though.
Oh, he's a great dude, boy. He makes every day going to the rink, I'm sure, fun.
There's a chip on goal on that pass by Brodin and a good save by Mrazek.
I was going to say, is it like wine? No, he actually likes wine.
When I read it, I thought the same thing. Yeah. It must be a wine aficionado. No, he just likes grapes.
There's a shot. Pad save. Anderson with a lock and a pad save by Fleury. And the rebound was headed towards Foligno, but albeit abbreviated. Meantime, here's a steal. It's Zuccarello on the attack with a shot. Bomb save Mrazek. Nice stop there. And he keeps the play going.
Oh, smart play right there. Good alertness.
Here comes Bedard. 2-on-2 with Hall. Connor Bedard leaves the puck for Jones. Seth Jones trying to get a front, jabs it on goal, three down, his goal! Jones able to bounce it in, and the Hawks are back within one.
What an effort at one end by Peter Mrazek, making a great glove save. Jones punched it up the ice, And Connor Bedard drops it back to Jones. Jones makes a power move there, going to the front of the net. Marc-Andre Fleury went for the poke check right here. There's the extension. There's the poke. It goes off the heel of his stick, off the skate of Jones, and then he pushes it in off the pad, and it finds its way across the goal line. That's a big goal late in the first.
So 4-on-4 is now a 4-on-3. And Panger will get his abacus out during the second intermission to try and figure this all out before we start the third.
Right? Oh, yeah, absolutely. I'll be right on that.
Wilder on the power play. Here's Zuccarello. Lets it go. Scores. Top corner. Just a quick snapshot. Finds the twine. And Wild back up by two.
Yeah, with Eriksson at right in front of the net. That was a perfect screen right there. And Zuccarello beyond Jones. So Jones is going to come up and put some pressure on him once the puck goes back to Faber's left right here. And then as this puck goes through, it's almost the middle of the net. But you can see Mrazek's looking to his right, and the puck just blows by his left side right there. Sometimes you look on the right side and you catch a break. Other times you look at the wrong side. And
22 seconds, and then the Wild will have another power. Lots of overlapping penalties. Tons of special teams in this game. It's kind of been the theme tonight.
Yeah, you did the math, right?
Oh, yeah, I've got it all broken down now. We'll get Neil deGrasse Tyson in a minute to explain it. Here's Faber! Scores! He tucks it in through the five hole. And a 4-on-4 goal to go with their two power play goals, and the Wild open up a 4-1 lead.
Faber, if you see on the left side of your screen, watch this puck comes over. You can see he lost an edge right there, pushing to his left. And then once that happened, you can see that it was wide open right here. And Faber takes the puck from Eriksson Ek, a little forehand, backhand move right between the legs.
Puck back to the line to Faber. Zuccarello fires it over. Kaprizov double clutch, and Mrazek falls, able to make a save, and he covers up.
Somehow Mrazek's able to get that left pad as he's falling on his stomach. Great. Oh, there. And
get things turned the other way now and chip away at this Minnesota lead. Johansson gains the line with a pass across back to Johansson, and he scores. Tucked in. Nice give and go there, and it was Ogren who fed the return pass across, and it's 5-1.
Minnesota Wild are beating the Hawks at the give and go game. I mean, making good passes, executing with speed on sticks, and strong on the play here. And you can see this is a situation where it's a 2-on-2, except that the wide player who ended up being Ogren, he's wide open, and then when he gets it, then Phillips goes over towards him. Former coach Brian Killian will turn 90 on October 20th.
Big celebration up there for him on his 90th birthday.
I'm going to go see him.
Here's a chance. Johansson turned aside by Mrazek, came out to challenge and got a piece of that one and steered it up over the glass into the netting.
Out, you're facing the rush right here, and you can see Marco Rossi tying up the stick there of Phillips, and that's a smart veteran move by Rossi, only in his second year. Right there, just tying it up just a little bit, and it gets right through the seam. Maybe if that's...
Murphy flips it up the boards, just out of the reach of Mikheyev. Back on the attack, Eriksson Ek drops it off. Zuccarello put it in front, they score! Might have been chipped in front by Kaprizov, who was headed to the net. Either way, 6-1 Minnesota.
He pulls it back in. Here's Eriksson Ek in the middle of the ice with these guys. He pulls it back in. Oh, he put it right. I mean, he
beautiful.
Put this right on the tape. Through seams at full speed, you get a better look at it and an appreciation of how accurate Zuccarello is with his passes. Really.
They've been the Hawks' most effective line most of the time.
They have been. They've been the most consistent line.
Here's Johansson with a bit of room right in. Stopped by Mrazek, able to fight it off, and he covers up for a faceoff.
6-1 game, but here's the play by Mrazek and Johansson. I love this move right here. Just kind of pull it across, see if the goalie drops to his stomach, and then just kind of flip it over him. And Johansson protects the puck right there and tries to flip it, but Mrazek's hands are already kind of smothering it with the angle of where his hands were. Keep your eye on his glove hand, and now he pushes it forward and cats it right off the top of the glove. And then it bounces harmlessly. Easy cover-up right there. From the shooter's eyes, I'm sure he's thinking there's a lot more room.
Play it behind the net to the other side, and Wild should be able to get it out. Bertuzzi cut it off. Good play at center. Three Hawks back on the attack. Here's Bedard. Slows it down. Cuts to the middle. Glove save. Fleury. Nice stop there is Bedard.
The glove side, and he took it away. But that's also, you know, the preparation that you have against Connor Bedard. And Good glove save there by Marc-Andre. This cutback move right there. Smart move right there by Connor, and he gets some pretty decent wood on that one as well. Let's take one last look at it right there as Bertuzzi gave him the drop pass. And
now there's the... And then a bump by Rossi draws a bit of a reaction as the horn sounds, and this one comes to an end.